Hello, everybody, and welcome back to another episode of XCOM 2. We are making progress here, just one day away from good old
Commander. We've located one of their facilities.
From good old making contact. Ooh, in Madagascar. All right. Alien facility in South Africa. Well, I tell you what, Oceania is kind of more important because that's going to get us to this mega facility over there once we're done making contact. I have a feeling this is just another one of those little making contact
new
things.
Regional contacts located.
Ooh, Chilean peppers. Supply drop is in 0 days, so I have a feeling like we're gonna be going to the supply drop.
Incoming message for you, Commander.
Yeah, here it is.
Patching it through to your quarters now.
I had high hopes for the resistance under your leadership, Commander.
Doctors.
And you have outdone yourself.
We actually did really good. Actually, we did quite well. And this thing. So we've got a hidden event. Whoa, what? Extra chrysalids? No. That's... Let that happen, whatever the fuck. But hell no for that. I almost wonder if I should reveal this just to see. Because if it's anything like that, I want to know about it. Oh, fuck. Jesus. Like, that's so
Avenger
useless.
New course.
Like, go ahead, do that. I don't care. So, we should be... We only passed one day. So, I think we're 6 days from, Terry recovering. Alejandro just recovered, so that's cool. We got all our money here. Let's ignore this. And we're gonna ignore that as well. Let's go just sort of survey for half a second here. We're recruiting here. That's not what I wanted. I wanted my proving ground. Where are we with my proving ground? 7 days for my Wraith suit. Okay. Psy operative training, 2 days. Okay. Resistance comms is there. We could double that. Okay, so let's go into build items. Let's go into weapons. Let's get that alien psi amp. Boom. Boom. Alright. The slashing and dashing isn't really something we're doing at the moment. Let's get our power upgraded here so that we might be able to free up. We might be able to free up. So that gets us 6.
Power relay upgraded.
How much money do we have left over? 137. So that should let us empty one of those, which it did, which should let us put it into the proving ground. Like so. So that makes it 4 days. Alright. Anything else that I can build item-wise? Weapon-wise? I could get the Gremlin. Significantly increasing the hacking stat of all specialists. And you know, the hacking stat is getting more and more tasty looking. You know, the shotgun isn't bad either. Let's take a quick peek see over at the old black
Avenger
market, because we should have a new range of things to look over since it's a new month. They got new stock. Supplies is exactly what I was looking for. 23 intel, I'll do that. Grenadier, I'm not about that. I'm not about that life. Tell you what though. 264 supplies. 284 supplies. Let's check something real quick here. Do I have enough intel to make contact with you just where you are? 90 intel. No, I don't. So, building this costs 150 supplies. Wow. Okay. So if I wanted shit. I mean, I guess you almost have to there, eh? Just kind of build the old relay there. All experimental ammo, grenade, and weapon proving ground projects are completed instantly. Oh, that'd be so nice. South F. Which is the one? Suit up. This is the one. We're a ways away from that. We're three. We got three things to go for that. You know what? I suppose we do this. We install the radio relay. Because then that's going to be 30, and that's going to be 60. And then we're just going to have to build another one. But yeah, I think we do. I think we do that. I think that's the...
For the Australian sector.
That's the good choice for the long run. Keep things affordable. So we're going to do that. 4 days. It's going to take me 4 days. Oh, we did this. Wonder what that does now.
Hate to do this, but you're the only one who can pull this off. You know, I'd go myself if I could.
The gateway is primed. Is the subject prepared?
Ready. I hardwired what was left of the Codex brain into Rover.
Okay.
It should be emitting the same signal the Codex used to pass through the gateway.
Excellent. Let us begin.
This could be interesting.
We've already seen the Codex opening a similar rift in the field. I am sure your device will be fine.
So fine. It's got a roll cage for the Codex brain, so of course it's gonna be fine.
There. We're set to record across all spectrums.
Remember, go in, take some quick readings, then come right back through. Okay.
Ooh. Going through the warp gate.
Whoa. Are you seeing this?
Nope, not really.
It appears our signal has been received. Increasing power.
Doesn't look like any place we've been before. Or any place on Earth, for that matter.
Perhaps this is the source. The aliens' seat of power, if you will. Secure beyond any physical limitations.
Only one way to find out.
Send an army in. Right? Right?
Go on.
No?
We're counting on you.
I have a feeling this is going to cause like huge retaliation.
That is definitely not fine, Doctor.
The process did work. There was an instant where the device was in between locations. However, once that occurred, the gateway called for a second signature, an organic signature. When we could not provide one, it generated a sort of feedback pulse.
Obviously.
If the Codex creates the door, this organic signature must surely be the key.
Well, we better make sure we have the right key before we try again. I would hate for this to occur to something organic.
Agreed. I'll report our findings to the commander immediately.
It's okay, I was here the whole time. So, I saw everything.
You're now prepared to autopsy the body of the powerful being we recovered, Commander.
Alright, yeah.
I feel
that we may be on the cusp of attaining a complete understanding of this avatar.
Just need that. Alright, so we researched that.
This creature represents a near-perfect fusion of human and elder DNA.
Though remarkable, and punk rock.
It appears as if the creature were unfinished. Perhaps why we were able to ultimately defeat it. Still, this can lead me to only
unfinished.
One logical
that
conclusion.
Doesn't sound good. What just happened?
We had such hope for you.
I believe we have found our avatar.
No, it's punk rocker. We already know that we found a punk rocker. So that's not really news. Ooh, psi training. And now, who are we gonna lose? East Asia. The only problem is I have a relay tower there, but I'm about to build a relay tower. So, it's not the end of the world. And considering where our... I'm just thinking, like... Because here's the thing. I don't need to prevent that from happening. And I don't think we're going to. Looking at everything. I don't think we're going to. I think we're going to let that happen. We've sort of let them retaliate. Well, the last two times they retaliated in the eastern U.S., they retaliated in the new Arctic. That might have been one of the things I forgot to mention to you guys. And I think we're going to let them retaliate here because we kind of don't need... I forgot that we have access to that. But we don't need to be there at this point in time. We're not getting the arm to the teeth thing. I think we let it happen, to be honest. I think we skipped the mission. Yeah. Alright. Does guaranteed psionic damage to an organic enemy, ignores cover and armor. Let's continue the training for a while. But
depending on who you ask, psionics could be considered the alien's greatest threat. Now our own Psy operatives can tap into that same power.
Galak's like pretty badass. What's going on? Oh, whoa. This is like completely stuns the target for one turn, but renders them immune to any damage or attack. Transfers half of the damage done back to the Psy operative as health. Immune to fire, poison, acid, and explosive damage. I don't like any of these, really. I mean, I suppose stasis could be cool. I suppose that could be cool. But I don't know. So Soulfire does guaranteed psionic damage to an organic enemy. It looks cool. Plus 40. That's because you got that gun thing. It doesn't look cool. Certainly, once we give you the Wraith suit, I'm sure it will. I'm sure it will be neat. Where am I going now? We were making contact. We let the retaliation happen. Everybody was mad at us for it. What's going on here? You growing?
Commander, we want to set back the aliens' work on the Avatar project.
So that's
we should hit one of their facilities as soon as possible.
That's a 3-star now? So I guess that's what we're going to hit.
Low local resistance forces in this region have gone into hiding after the recent setback.
Boom, boom. Terry recovered from wounds. What's going on now? Avatar project's going up. Okay, so we gotta go. We gotta go hit that facility.
Commander, the aliens continue to make progress on the Avatar project. If we're going to slow them down, we'll need to move.
Don't worry, guys. Don't worry, guys. We've been here before. It's fine. Proving ground. Wraith suit. Excellent. So incorporating an experimental warp technology to briefly change dimensional phase and effortlessly pass through obstacles. Ew. Sounds cool. I think that's like teleporting. It's gotta be teleporting. I figured though that it was like specifically for, like, I thought that was, it was something that was specifically for, you know, our people. Oh no. So this gives somebody the ability to teleport. It's not specifically for our psionic guys. Alright, well that makes me feel silly, doesn't it? how many cores do we have? Let's build another war suit with the rockets, I'm thinking. Or maybe... maybe some plasma grenades? Yeah. More lethal. That would be good, actually. Throw that on Joe instead of the acid grenade, maybe. Or, how much money does that cost? And how much money are blue screen rounds? I think I build one of these. And I think we go back to engineering, we build items, and we build some more blue screen rounds. Yeah. Because I think we want someone else with blue screen as well, considering just how crazy things are getting with the robots.
Signal's coming through clear.
So that's awesome. Fire when ready. Cool. Alright, where are we as far as... our peoples are concerned. Where are we as far as our soldiers are concerned? 3 and 4 days. So let's spend 3 days, because that will do the stasis training and we'll get you two back. Mainly because we want two specialists on our trip, on our journey. Where could we spend 3 days? I guess making contact with you.
Setting course for the Chilean control district.
Yeah, we may as well just make contact with you. Get busy here. It's gonna be 4 days, but that's okay.
It won't be easy, but I think it's the only option we have at this point.
Agreed.
What's that?
We must inform the commander immediately.
Go right ahead.
Commander, Central, the Shadow Chamber has completed its analysis of the Avatar's DNA. It has identified the genetic sequence necessary to travel through the psionic gate.
Perfect. We can finally shut this Avatar project down for good.
However, the gate requires more than a mere transmission of genetic data.
The sequence has to be part of a live subject. The key only works in lockstep with the signal.
We don't have time to find another one of those things, let alone capture it.
No. That part we can handle. We make our own.
You're serious?
Quite. Though the specimen before us is damaged beyond repair, it has provided us with its complete genetic blueprint. We already possess an unaltered Avatar template from the Forge facility. That combined with the genetic material we recovered at the Black Site should allow us to replicate the procedure here.
So, what's the catch?
Yes, that. Without an Elder consciousness driving it, the new Avatar would remain as lifeless as the one before us. While I can develop its body, I cannot create the mind to drive it.
But I can, in a way. By manipulating the new Avatar, via the psionic network.
You want to operate one of these things? by remote control?
Not exactly. And definitely not me.
Interfacing directly with their network would cause severe, if not fatal, trauma to an unprepared central nervous system. As it stands, we only know of one individual who has survived that kind of ordeal.
That's me. Yeah. What's up, guys?
That was different. The stasis suit
created the perfect interface to the network, one tailored to your specific biology, Commander. Of any human candidate, you are the most likely to survive the connection.
Most likely is not good enough, Doctor.
It is the only answer I can give you, and our only option to traverse the alien portal.
We need to come up with a game plan before we charge through the enemy's front door.
I feel like this is like the last mission, so Commander. I really want
this
to save
this being is something
people.
Else entirely, something beyond anything we have ever seen, and yet somehow our
yeah.
troops once again prevailed.
So nothing. Nothing to research here. I guess we're just,
Priority message for the commander coming through on a secure channel, sir.
On screen.
Sir, it's coming from the Advent Network Tower.
You heard me. He's taking a big risk contacting us like this.
Hello, Commander. You and your crew are to be commended. Your efforts in rebuilding the Resistance Network and uncovering the truth about the Avatar Project have been admirable. I only wish I had better news to report.
When does he ever?
Advent is not taking the death of an elder lightly, and in turn have greatly accelerated the final stages of their Avatar Project. A plan is now in place for the rapid processing of all non-essential human life. To
Jesus.
Begin immediately. Very soon, Advent's speaker will announce a breakthrough in gene therapy. A final treatment for the human condition. Billions will flock to gene therapy clinics across the globe. They will never return. I have managed to secure tactical data and access codes to the Advent Network Tower. The speaker's address will be broadcast live to a global audience via this facility. The whole of Advent's network will be listening. It is this hubris that we must use against them.
Yeah, and hijack the signal.
The information I am sending you should allow Dr. Tigan and Chief Engineer Shen to take control of the transmission and disrupt their entire network from within. Though my hope is that this disruption will confuse the enemy's forces long enough to allow your final assault a chance of success, I ask one more thing of you. Take what you have learned. Let the world know what is happening here. Wake them up. Broadcast the truth. Before there is no one left to listen. It seems we are both out of time. Farewell, Commander.
You mean we're not gonna get his, like,
added.
Shitty little end of the month stuff?
We're ready to move when you are, Commander. I've updated our objectives based on the latest information. We have the target site locked in, Commander. This is our chance to strike at Advent's heart. Once we control the network tower, we can finally show the world what the aliens are doing. There's no turning back after this.
Oh, man. I have to do this now? I can't do anything else? I mean, like, I guess I don't want to, but, like... I can't
Commander,
do that.
Once we move on the Advent Network Tower, it's all or nothing. We won't have time to advance our research or deal with the wounded. We should only deploy once we're fully prepared.
So that is the final... That is the final mission. Is what they're telling me there. I don't think we're ready for that just yet. We definitely need to heal up. I'll tell you that much. Inspire. Like, that's really good. Grant a bonus action. Let's back out, though. Just for now. I mean, yeah. Get him training. For sure. Maybe we won't bring him into this next mission. When we assault the facility here. Right there.
Long live the resistance.
Just making new contact.
Regional contacts located.
Brazil. Let's get rid of this guy here. Archon, Codex, Gatekeeper, Elite Trooper, Elite Lancer, Muton, Elite Officer. Assault the facility. Okay. Who we got here? Sonya, let's get you out of here for right now. Who we bring in? We're gonna bring... I can bring you, yeah. I can. I mean, like, got an alien psi amp. You got a psionic ability. You're an acolyte. I suppose we'll try you. Should I throw Mind Shield on you? Can I throw? I guess we don't throw Mind Shield on you. I guess that would be kind of counterintuitive. Right. okay, so we've got a psionic soldier. Let's try it. Let's try it out. Who are we giving blue screen rounds to? Definitely Alejandro is going to get a blue screen round. We're also going to throw... Why can't I throw mind shields on peoples? Why can't I throw mind shields? Is it because all the mind shields are taken? Do I need to... Is that why? Do I need to take the mind shield away from people? I thought they were infinite. Like, they were acting... I guess they're not infinite anymore. Okay. Alright. Where were you? Down here? Do we want to take Daily? Who would we take in Daily's, like, who would Daily come in favor of? I know, I like having a sniper too much, and we're sabotaging an alien facility. I like having a sniper way too much. You know... No. No, I think we're fine. I think we're fine. I think we throw blue screen rounds onto you. We actually can put a mind shield. Okay. Alright, well, we'll do that for sure. And maybe blue screen rounds on you. I don't know why I'd put blue screen rounds on you. I don't know why I would do that. Considering your aim is at 69, that doesn't make sense. No, we're not going to do that. But we are going to put blue screen rounds on someone with really good aim, or someone like Joe, who's got room. So now we can split up the blue screen. We got Joe and we got Alejandro, who are robot killers. Joe's got the EMP. He's got the blue screen rounds. We got a bunch of mind shields. Are we fighting a gatekeeper? Yes, we are. So let's just remove you for a second so that I can throw in Daily so that I can get rid of your mind shield here. Solely for the purpose of putting that onto Alejandro here. We do have a Wraith suit we can give someone. We also have an Exo suit we can give someone. So Wraith adds dodge and mobility. And you can, Wraith allows the unit to pass directly through obstacles for two turns. Grapple, that's a grappling hook. Okay, well, it has the grapple as well.
Our Celsius suit, the Wraith, provides a range of movement that technically violates the laws of physics.
I love that. Also a grappling hook for good measure. Okay, so it is the direct successor to the spider suit. Okay. Okay, and it's got two extra health from the spider suit, and it also adds to your dodge. Well, I guess the spider suit also added to the dodge. Okay. It also added to your mobility. Does it make sense for you to have that, though? Like, the grappling hook I definitely get, but the passing through walls, maybe not. I don't know. I suppose just because of the grappling hook, maybe. Who else would we want to pass through walls? Maybe, like, Joe? I don't know. I really don't know. I think we're good, though. You know, we spent so much time thinking about this thing. Your frag grenade can be an acid grenade. And it appears as though putting on the armor gets rid of a second slot. Well, that's news. Okay. Well then, Alejandro, you're going to be far enough back that we'll use the blue screen rounds. Sounds good? Sounds good. Okay. Let's do it. Let's launch the mission. Got to sabotage an alien facility. Get out alive. We have a psionic soldier. That's new. That's different. We haven't done that before.
In position for deployment.
You know, a couple scary enemies that we need to deal with, but overall, I think we should be fine.
Hidden in this area, conducting research crucial to the Avatar project, and we've got enough information at this point to move.
So
in
we
got to
plant the charges, and we got
to
get out.
Once we reach the AO, head to the designated position and plant the X4 charges.
And then,
armed, get clear,
and then we basically decide whether or not we're, you know, we're gonna heal up and attack the other facility and keep buying us time until we've got everybody trained, or if we just go for that last mission. I think I certainly want some more intel because I want to go in with as many of the bonuses as I can. Because bringing an extra squad member, like, that would be huge. Having a seventh man, that would be huge.
Target coordinates are locked in. Move to designated position and place the X4 charges.
Okay. We're completely outside. Everybody's concealed. Terry gets the run up because Terry gets the ever vigilant trait. So if you're running there, then you're running from here. So we'll just run you here to make sure nobody's there. It's gonna make things bad. Doesn't appear so. So you're gonna keep running. See anything? No, you don't. All right. Well then, we should be good to run Sam up there. Everybody's still concealed. Everything's going good. This is Vaseline. Moisturizer. Vasily. I guess Vaseline. We can call him, moist or slippy or, I don't know, something.
Will do.
That was two codexes and an archon. Is that what I saw up there? I think. Pretty sure that's what we saw. Two codexes and an archon. Can only see one codex now, but pretty sure. So the high ground and that little tower not doing us much good as far as Alejandro is concerned, because that does not help when you've got no cover facing you. So I suppose that we will run Alejandro here. Probably would have made more sense to run him towards the middle of the map, but
eyes on the prize.
Couple ever vigilance. Not that that really mattered, because we're all so far away. So Sammy Poo, why don't you run there?
Confirmed.
Take a peek. We got an advanced turret. Guarantee you there's another patrol somewhere. We don't have a turn limit. So I am certainly of the mind to really take my time here and get in a good flank and get to where we want to be in our life before we make any heavy decisions, you know what I mean? Like, really get to know each other and get comfortable with the kids at school and just be able to make informed decisions about who we hang out with and what program we go into and all that kind of thing. Pistol Overwatch is gonna happen there. Joe, I don't want to bunch up too much. Maybe there is actually good.
Double time.
Yeah, I like that. I like that location. Then we're good. Then you can just go into Overwatch.
Eyes on the prize.
And you went into Overwatch as well, so that's good. Here comes another patrol. This is kind of what we were waiting for, because I was pretty sure that this was going to happen. You're just one lonely soldier? No, of course not. You're an elite soldier and a captain. And there's probably more to that. Let's get off of you, because you're scaring me here. So if I threw a blue screen round with Joe, that would hurt both the codexes. It would hurt both the codexes. So a soul fire just guaranteed psionic damage to an organic enemy. Ignores cover and armor. That's really cool. Completely stuns the target for one turn. That's really, because that I could completely stun like a sectopod and then kill all the ads. Alejandro, how are you doing as far as what you can see? You've got 100% on basically everybody, eh? So we could get you a 100% kill theoretically. I really wish that there was a way for me to attack everybody at once. Like, what does this rocket do? Like, this rocket, I can do like that, and I'm pretty sure that also gets buddy friend. And then we can kind of pick up the pieces of the Codex and the Archon as we go. Like, who's more dangerous to me? Who is more dangerous to me? Like, that's the real question here. I gotta think. Unleash a hail of bullets that is guaranteed to hit your target, but uses a lot of ammunition. This is very interesting. So, guaranteed to hit, but it uses three. Okay. I like the whole guaranteed thing, though. Send an aid protocol over to Sam. Because Sam is in half cover right now. So before I forget, because if I'm triggering things this turn, or maybe we just overwatch, you know, maybe this turn isn't the turn that we do things. Maybe we overwatch right now. Everybody's kind of behind trees, but with the rocket, like, I could get that. I really don't know, man. Everybody's behind trees. I just moved him into Overwatch, so I think that kind of...
Overwatch.
But then I wasted... Then I kind of also wasted the thingy, but...
On Overwatch.
I think we see what they do this turn. See what they do. Give them one more turn to move. They're moving towards us, so we're going to get a better idea of who's who, who's what, who's where. Only two people. So, it's kind of not super scary. You know, to be blunt, it's not really scary. So what I'm thinking is we definitely want Sam in an Overwatch, because I think we shoot the blue screen round across. I think we throw an aid protocol on Sam, and then we also go into Overwatch as well.
Affirmative. Covering now.
Then Joe, you're gonna send a blue screen around. EMP grenade. That's what I meant. You're gonna send it this way. Damage both the codexes.
Catch.
And then we're gonna go from there. That was 8 damage, so that really did good, and that stunned one of them. So let's see what happens here. Archon is all pissed off about it. This is actually triggering Terry. Wasn't exactly what I was thinking. I was kind of thinking that these two would shoot the others, but I mean, shooting the Archon is good too. I suppose. We also have the turret. Okay, Battle Frenzy, yes. Alright. So, what do you have? You got him. Unable to do anything. So, I don't think we shoot him just yet. You know, I think we... Who else can shoot? Alejandro can shoot. So, he's got a 99 on that thing. He's got a 91 on you. An 85 on you. 81 on you. 57 on you. Let's serial. For every kill made with a sniper, your actions will be refunded.
Listo para más.
Let's serial here. And let's start going down the chain. See how many kills Alejandro can get. Alright.
Sigue en movimiento.
The hubris, it gets me every time. All right. Let's make sure the Archon's dead. Because I don't want to have to deal with... I don't want to have to deal with his there little pylons and it forcing me to move. And then let's stun the officer.
Armor of the mind.
Yeah. And then I didn't realize I'd get another thing. And then let's soul fire this elite trooper. Only 6 damage, but that's okay. 8 damage would have killed him, but you know, it's fine. So now we'll let you guys go. Codex is no longer stunned. But that should be your whole turn, is that you're no longer stunned. Why? What? How do you get a turn after being stunned? I don't understand that. I don't understand that. You were stunned. Now you're on Overwatch. You're running here. Who are you taking a shot at, Alejandro? Wow, okay. Alejandro, you're gonna get another shot at this whole serial thing, hopefully. Miss. Okay, good. Alright.
There's heavy fire in this zone.
A lot of people are flanked. So that motherfucker's on Overwatch right there. So is the turret. So is the turret. Turret's on Overwatch. Are you in the thing? You shouldn't be, because, you know, logic. You can't do serial again, eh? No. You're flanked. Who are you flanked by? You're flanked by that dude. No, you're flanked by that dude. You're probably flanked by kind of both of them. All right. Let's get this guy dead, right? Can we agree on that? I think we can agree on that. Let's get this guy dead. Overwatch removed. One less Overwatch to worry about. Now, as far as this is concerned, you need to reload. You get a free reload, though. I think that's still in the range of things. That's the only problem I'm seeing. Is anything behind me? Yeah, that codex. We'll be able to kill that codex. I'm counting on being able to kill that codex. So, I think I run there with Terry.
What's over there?
This is triggering the turret. You took 4 damage. That's okay. I'm fine with you taking 4 damage. You're a trooper. You've got a lot in you. You're gonna fire this dude's face. Yeah, I'm appreciating that was a kill. Vaseline needs to move and reload. And that's pretty much all you're gonna be able to do. No, that's okay, because you did a lot last turn. Okay. Joe, we need to get you out of here. Because I don't trust your location. Even though it says you're fine, I don't trust that for a second. Let's clear. Move you there. You should be able to shoot that, I suppose. So do that. 14 damage. I mean, 14 damage was a little overkill, but I like the enthusiasm. You know, we can't say that enthusiasm is a bad thing. So let's get some gremlin heals. May as well. We'll use Steve's turn to heal Alejandro and Terry. And just get them feeling 100% in their life. And 99, eh? Would you be? I guess you take it out. Yeah, let's take that out completely if you can. I would have done that at the start of the turn had I thought about it in that respect. Did that kill it? Did that destroy the turret? Yeah, it did. All right, so we just have to deal with the officer now. That's good. So what's the officer gonna do? Oh, what the fuck? Yeah, that was me being stupid. That's how Cody Rhodes dies, man. That's... Oh, he moved. Yeah, he moved into a flanking position.
Hostiles got me flanked!
I noticed. Alright. Well. What do you do when a hostile flanks you? You flank the hostile. That's what you do. You just kind of walk around the corner and you say, hey, what up, buddy? Can you die? And then he says, I can die. But... You know, not right away. So you take Alejandro and can you fire your pistol from there? 59% for your pistol. I mean like we may as well just kill you with Alejandro. May as well just kill you. Gets dead. Now let's get some people healing. Because some people need healing now. The people that need healing, we're going to get Terry to heal them.
Go help him out.
Like so. Get our two little dudes healed. We're not going to move a whole bunch, but we're going to get Joe Heerish. Put him in Overwatch. We just dealt with six people. I'm pretty sure we dealt with six. Two soldiers, three over there, and a turret. Over. Why? Did I just accidentally double heal the other dude?
No,
it just wasn't showing up. Oh, that's great. I love when it's not showing up and that's what happens.
Affirmative,
okay, it's cool. You're the only one left, so let's just run you up.
Roger that.
And get you an Overwatch. Get you a nice little Overwatch. Alright. Alright. That seems to be a main door. Right there. So with that in mind, Alejandro, do you think that would be good? Like, are you covered? You're not going to be too flanked by anything if you're up there? Kind of hoping the answer is yes. Sam, run up there. Just take a little peek. See what's going on. Everything's good? Okay. So we're going to Overwatch.
Covering now.
Vasily, Vaseline buddy, you're gonna run. Yeah, we're not gonna go too crazy. We're just gonna leapfrog and get some Overwatches going because we are in the late game. Should be playing this smart. I say as I consider running Terry up further than the others. Only because of her Overwatch ability of course, but yeah, no, it makes sense to run her there.
Affirmative.
Most cover. And if she can successfully go there, then let's get Steve. Let's make sure you're able to overwatch just in case something comes from the side. Because we haven't seen anything. Well, no, we said the codexes did specifically come from that side. But, alright. We've got Alejandro up here just in case. I mean, it doesn't look like that's going to be useful. That was kind of more if people showed up when I was moving up here. Then having you up there was going to be useful the next time, type of thing. So let's move Terry here first.
I guess that'll be okay.
Just in case that triggers something. We do have a gatekeeper to worry about. So let's keep that in mind, that there's a gatekeeper coming.
Let's move already!
This saw something? Oh, I saw a turret. Oh, really? Okay. Of course, now you can't see the turret, so it's almost like a moot point. Unless we were to move... Where was the turret? It was like way up there. I doubt Alejandro would even be able to hit that from where he is. No, it wouldn't make sense. Let's just get you to Overwatch. Get you to Overwatch. Nobody can see the turret. The turret isn't... Is that really a smart move? No, it's not. That's the answer is no, it's not a smart move.
Step it off.
And we're not gonna run you all the way up. But we're gonna run you there.
Getting it done.
We got some Overwatches to put in on. And Alejandro, we will run up there.
No hace falta repetirlo.
Indeed. Indeed. Alright, getting everybody move up. We spotted a turret, but I'm pretty sure that doesn't matter because nobody can see it. Okay, so let's get Terry.
If you say so.
And let's get Joe.
Alright,
I'll on
go.
The old door frame here. Yeah, we'll kind of go from here. Let's open this door. What do we see? Yep, this is what I was thinking. I was thinking we were gonna have something like this happen, where that thing just runs through a goddamn wall, because it doesn't give a shit about anything. You got a barrel there. That would be interesting to shoot. Let's make sure you take a shot at the old gatekeeper here. Hopefully you hit him. That would be really nice. You didn't. You missed. We did get some holo targeting on him.
Missed.
So that's important. Alejandro, where are you? Here you are. Good old 86%. Yeah. Sam, where are you? There you are. Good old Rocket. Yeah. I'm liking the Rocket, actually. Really digging the Rocket. Look at what the Rocket can do for me. And that'll shred some, so let's do that. Yep, 5 damage. Open up everything. Of course, you're flanked by that now, but... Steve... We got an aid protocol, so let's do that on... You do have 2 moves, right, Steve? Let me check that. Yeah, you do. Let's get an aid protocol on Terry. And let's take your 86% now. Alright, let's... do that. 10 damage. I'll take 10 damage. 10 damage I will take. How are you doing on this? 68. Am I able to stasis it? For now? How many more people go? You both go. I actually like that. Let's stasis it where it is now.
Shields up.
Just like this. Boom. Stasis. Alright. That's awesome. That's actually so amazing. That ability. So you got Soulfire, you can get a kill on him. May as well, I suppose.
Your head.
Nice little kill. I don't know, I just get a kill. It was kind of stupid because really probably shouldn't have been doing that. But I'm going to throw these two on Overwatch. Throw an aid protocol on Joe, because he's the only other one that Lancer might go for. Of course, throwing an aid protocol on Joe meant that Terry can't go on Overwatch, but... So we're... That was kind of actually really silly of me. And he missed. Alright, well, let's see what the aid protocol does. Shit, man. Come on. Alright. Is the stasis just for that one turn? Is the stasis done? Yeah, stasis is done now. I do really, really like that ability. Because it just prevents... it prevents the dude from... hurting people, man. Like, it prevents it. Let's see about good old fashioned kill on you. Who's taking hits? Just Terry right now, eh? So definitely want Joe to take the first shot, just because of the old hollow targeting rule. Get hit with shoot. Occasionally he'll blow the fuck out of it like that.
So I got one.
And then we're good. So get a gremlin heal on yourself there, Terry. Sam.
Heal bot coming through.
We're gonna run up and we're gonna give you an Overwatch. I'm pretty sure. No, there's mutons. We're missing mutons. I'm remembering now that there should be mutons on this map and we haven't seen any.
Moving to Overwatch.
So that's a thing that still is to come.
Desde luego.
Valandra up, maybe give the gun a reload, because pistol Overwatch isn't really going to help us. Alright. So it must be... There's a muton. And another gatekeeper. Another one.
I'll get him next time.
Okay. Well. Two mutons and another gatekeeper. I don't know if I'm okay with that. Thank God we weren't fighting two gatekeepers at once. But, fuck. Okay. Okay. Joe, you get a free reload. Hey, you got 58% on him.
Ready to rock.
He Yeah, does anybody... somebody's got a grenade. Yeah, you do. You've got an acid grenade. Can you get it there? I can't really see here. Can you get it so that it gets both of them? No, but you can get it there. Which I like. We'll do that. It gets some shred. It gets some shred, which is good. We rotate. We move there. Is that good, though? That I like, because then you can get a flank. Can get a flank on that muton. You need to reload whatever you do. And then you, I'm thinking, if you move here, you get a bit of a better shot. You get a, get rid of the old flank, and you can take a shot here. And if it's a lucky 50-50, which it wasn't a lucky 50-50. Where are we at now? Who we got? We got Alejandro, Terry, Sam, and Steve. Okay. Steve. Andrew, you got 71 on you. You've got 86 on you. I could trigger a serial if it got to that point. Sam, you need to do the reload. You've got an 89 and a 79. I think that's for the slash, though. Yeah, that is for the slash. Gonna do the old run and gun. Get you in there. So that gets you a 76. I'll take the 76. 4 damage. Could be a lot better, but... Eh. You're only 67 on you. If I run you there, though...
Okay, I'll go.
Yeah, we're seeing the... Okay, I was really worried that we were gonna see another thing. But you've got a flank on this muton. This is what I'm talking about here. That's not what I'm talking about, though. Shit.
Gonna need to reload soon.
Okay. So, if you Deadeye, you're doing 19 to 21 damage, 65%. I am going to take that risk, I think. Because otherwise... No, let's... Before I make that call... Let's get Steve to shoot at it and see if he hits it. Yeah, we'll get Steve to take a hail of bullets. 7 to 9 damage. Well, it's probably not going to kill him. Let's get Alejandro to take a shot at it and see. Alright, just regular old shot. That did 10 damage. That's good. I like 10 damage. So that got it down 5. So your shot at it will do up to that. I don't even think it would be a guarantee, really. Let's shoot you. And you got that kill. Oh, that is so key. Okay. Yeah, one less thing to shoot. Really scared about what the gatekeeper does. Gatekeeper's burning from acid. I didn't even know it got an acid burn. Blade storm, that's good. Oh wow. Okay. I didn't even know you're really within melee range there. So what's it gonna do? It's gonna do something crazy. What is it doing? Oh, is that its resurrecting thing? I'm not even, did it damage anything? Okay, Alejandro got shot. What the fuck did the gatekeeper do? did anybody catch what the gatekeeper did? Am I crazy? Let's give the kill to buddy friend here. He'll take the kill, I'm sure. Isn't that a barrel that he's hiding behind? What is this? That's the barrel that he's hiding behind. That I find amusing. Let's just shoot that. Just out of principle. Whoop, didn't mean to pause it. Let's make sure that Gatekeeper's dead. That should pretty much kill Gatekeeper. That actually did a lot of damage to everybody. So you're gonna do restoration.
Give him the mist.
Yeah. I kind of forgot that the gatekeeper was a little bit explosive when he died. Yeah. A little bit explosive. So we're going to have a little bit of a wait period before we can do that last mission anyways, just on the basis of, the whole I'm just going to shoot this out of principle because I think that's the thing that is in front of him. Did 4 damage to him and now he's in the open. Classic. Is he not in the open? What's he hiding behind if he's not in the open? What is he hiding behind if he's not in the open? I think the game's glitching.
It's clear.
I shot away his cover and it's still... Okay, now it's not. Alright. Kill the Muton, Joe. Excellent. Good job. Alright.
One down, thousands to go. Drain an ammo fast!
Good. Yeah, Vasily. Why is everything on fire? Oh, because you're on fire. Oh. That kind of sucks. How about you run there, then?
I'm getting burned!
Yeah, no, I know. You can calm down, though. Pick up whatever that is, an Illyrium core and an advanced laser sight. Okay, body twitched. Alright, that creeped me out a lot. And that's just Alejandro. I don't want to be that guy that runs up and triggers the next thing. Even though he's done that so many infinite number of times, but I'm pretty sure everybody's
starting to get cocked!
Everybody's... Jesus, everything's fucking just...
Medic!
Did it 6 damage to Alejandro? What the fuck did 6 damage to Alejandro?
Menace 1-5, be advised, we've picked up hostile reinforcements inbound on your position.
Like, that thing just randomly blew up on Alejandro. Okay, so you guys still have some heals, so let's do that. You've got a heal.
Go patch him up.
And you... You're burning. Okay. Psychic dude. Move there. Do this thing. Set the charge. Figure out what our next you know, steps are. Do we
Menace
set
1-5, status confirmed.
Yeah, we do.
Charges are armed. Move to the extraction point for immediate evac.
So that's fine. We set the extraction point. So nobody has to worry. Everybody's gonna be okay.
I'm on the move.
We're gonna set the old extraction point right hereabouts, right in the middle. Got a nice open sky.
Get an evac in here!
There. And yeah, it's gonna be good. We're gonna get some overwatches. You know, people on this side, and just throw them in Overwatch, and put Joe right here, and put him in Overwatch, just because not everybody can make it to the evac zone at the moment. You're gonna get a reload. Earl's gonna put you in Overwatch. Alejandro. You're gonna really. Why don't you move there?
Yeah, boy.
And then move here. And look, you didn't go into the acid. Do you see how that happened? So the reinforcements came. Alright. Here they are. Landing in the trees. Oh, a couple of mechs. Jeez. That's some heavy duty reinforcements. Two heavy mechs and a shield bearer.
Advent forces on the ground.
That is like, that is armor heavy. They're gonna run on up and trigger some overwatches. 5 damage, 3 armor. Just a little bit of fun. I'm pretty sure that they can't go into Overwatch. I think, anyways. Jeez, why didn't you shoot first? All right.
Happy now.
Good stuff. Yeah, that did 1 damage of burning. It's fine. You're no longer burning, though. All right, so everybody can get out. Let's do that. Why don't you go there?
Order's confirmed. Moving out.
And get on out of the map, huh?
Packing it in.
We still have a psychic soldier. Psychic soldier didn't die.
Running.
Good to know. Am I right?
Let's move already.
All right. Get us all
good to go.
In the old spot-a-rooney. And get us all evacing, huh? Get those ropes from the heaven.
I'm out of here.
The heavens. Get lifted. Get risen up into the chopper. Alright. We did good. I mean, a lot of people got a little bit shot. Some people got a little bit burned. Others slightly exploded. But I think at the end of the day, it was a successful mission. You know, nobody died. Alejandro kind of came close to dying, just because he likes to keep things interesting. You know, Alejandro did have a glorious opportunity for a cereal at the beginning of that mission, and well, that was unfortunate. I had such high hopes there. I was like, man, 90 90 80 80 80, you're gonna be able to one hit half of these. Oh, that would have been so cool. Oh well. we won't blame you for that too much, Alejandro. It would have been cool, just saying. You know, kind of dropped the ball, but it's all right. It's all right. We won't judge you too harshly. Gonna be interesting to see who's gravely wounded. Holy hell, that psionic ability to throw the thing into stasis was so awesome. Use it exactly the way I envisioned in my mind. You know, I guess against the elite officer it maybe wasn't necessary, but against that gatekeeper, that one turn, it was really nice to just say, you know what, I'm gonna use stasis on you, and I'll just worry about you next turn. Like, that's so incredible. And as long as you do it at the end of your turn, you can get, you know, all of your guys shooting at it, throw it into stasis at the end if you don't kill it, type of thing. It could be your plan B. It could be your backup. So, I definitely want to be bringing him along. In the mission. So, gravely wounded is Joe, is Alejandro, and is Steve. But only wounded is Terry, Sam, and Vaseline there. Got a couple artifacts, alright. Reduce the project. The Avatar project by 3.
We should check with resistance.
A little thin on manpower. Let's check on how this looks. 12 days for some? Wow. Wow. Really 8 days until we're back into the swing of things, because Sonya can go in place of Alejandro, but boy oh boy, eh? So the Psylab, let's throw he's injured, gotcha. Alright, that's fine, injured, I can live with that.
This coil could provide us with some additional power for the Avenger systems, but we'll need to add some shielding first to protect the crew.
Oh, that's interesting. Shield power coil. That's what Steve was talking about. That's what you're talking about, how the power coils are down by the bottom. And that's kind of really terrible with how my game worked out, but oh well. It's okay. I think we did okay. We're gonna get another war suit soon. That'll be nice. People are injured, which kind of sucks. Let's take a look at the map. We were able to destroy that chili facility. And that was pretty good. We'll be able to destroy that facility next turn if we need to, if we feel like it. Supply drops in 9 days, so you know, supply drop is literally just after people start to get healthy. We'll have to really think about it. But that's a decision for next time. And I'll see you then.